Welcome back.
Well, do you ever wonder how much to spend on wedding gift or who's in charge of the shower?
Well, it is wedding week here on The Morning Blend, so we're tackling all those etiquette questions that are so important and burning in your mind. Etiquette expert and director of career services at Marquette University, Laura Kastner-Ricketts, is here to set us straight.
Yeah.
You always set us straight. That's what I love about you. Happy New Year.
Happy New
Year.
Good
to see you. Thank you. All right, let's start to get to these questions. Mm-hmm. Keep your answers brief, if you would. Who should I tell first about my engagement? Should I announce it on Facebook like our director's sister and like nobody knew she was even married? Until she posted it on Facebook.
She posted that she was married?
Yes, yeah. On Facebook. Wow. Nobody in the family knew. Is that a good idea?
I guess for shock value, yes.
Okay, so who should you tell first about an engagement?
An engagement. Okay, so there's a little protocol, the top five. So the first, parents.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Parents of the bride, parents of the groom, same-sex couple, pick and choose, you know.
Okay.
Then grandparents.
Oh,
if any
okay.
of them are living. Siblings.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Best friends.
Okay.
And then guess what the last one is before you tell the world?
Extended family?
Your boss.
Oh.
Your boss.
What?
Really?
Well, think about
That's
it.
That's fascinating.
So this might impact kind of time off, that kind
okay.
of thing.
Oh.
Good to tell your boss before.
Okay.
He or she finds out a different way, and then you can tell the world.
Okay.
Yeah.
And
okay.
post
That's
it.
What Emily Post said.
Okay.
I like
fascinating.
It. I like it.
Yeah.
yeah.
I like it too.
The next one is if you know someone can't attend, do you still send an invite to them?
Probably not.
Oh.
Typically, when you send an invite to someone, they're then obligated to send, they might feel obligated to send a gift. So the only reason you
gotcha.
Would send an invite to someone who you know can't attend is just so they can have it as a keepsake.
Okay.
Oh, see, I thought it would be courteous to send an invite mm-hmm. so they know they've been invited. But I get your point about the gift.
Right.
Okay.
I mean, if you already know they can't attend,
yeah.
then you've had some sort of conversation where they know they would have been invited anyway.
Okay. Okay. How can you push people to RSVP politely?
This is a really hard one. So I say enlist the help of your friends and family. So
okay.
kind of divide up who has an RSVP'd and say, okay, you know Aunt Shirley, Mom, get on Aunt Shirley.
Mm-hmm.
You know, kind of call your friends. Not literally.
Yeah.
So get on your friends, have them call or say, hey, you know, Susie hasn't heard from you. Can you help us out here? So
okay.
it's okay to harass them.
Okay. okay. How about being a bridesmaid? Can you get out of it?
You can get out of it. I've been a bridesmaid, I think it's like 7 times or something. I will never do it again.
Really?
So,
it's
no.
expensive and it's
hard.
So,
yeah, you know, and I'm old now. So really the best thing to do is just say no before you commit to it.
Mm-hmm.
The worst thing to do is back out of a commitment.
But can you back out?
You can back out if something happens.
Mm. Okay.
So think about, are you the only one? Were you asked because they asked all the sisters-in-laws?
Yeah.
And so, you know, I mean, if you're not a crucial part of the wedding party, that's probably okay. I know someone recently who did that. It's fine. I mean, if they're...
Is it okay to say no if, for example, you don't like the person that your friend or your relative is marrying? I mean, honestly, I think people... Was that a bad question?
No, I mean, yeah. If you're totally excited about this wedding, absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Absolutely. Now, do you say that? Probably not.
Okay.
Okay.
Maybe just say, you know, it's not going to work out. The timing's not good. Just say what you need to say.
And okay. you say be gracious and get a really good gift.
Yeah.
like
be gracious
that.
About it. Buy okay. a nice gift.
How long right. do you have to send a wedding gift?
Dun, dun,
Is it
dun.
To a year?
It's not. You know, I think that's sort of a myth.
Oops.
Really, you want to send a gift. In fact, what I've been reading is that more and more people want to send a gift ahead of time.
Mm-hmm.
So send it as soon as you maybe pick something off the registry, send it ahead of time to the couple. Or some places you might bring it to the wedding, depending on what's in fashion. Or you want to send it as soon as possible, really within 3 months.
Oops. 3 months, not
Oopsie.
A year. Okay, whoa.
Oops. I'm right, late
who,
on one.
Who hosts the bridal shower?
Yeah, this was really funny because when I was reading about this, apparently in the olden days it was really taboo for the bridal family, anyone there to host the shower, because it was really taboo because it seemed like then the family was, you know, getting rid of their daughter and getting gifts, right? typically anyone can host the shower now. The couple themselves probably don't want to do it, but really anyone else. The hard thing is that these days, typically a friend is going to do it, but so many people have all their friends in their wedding party. Mm-hmm. So if you're the maid of honor, you get stuck with all the costs of that and the shower and the bachelorette party. I mean, it's really expensive deal. So if you can kind of spread the wealth and get people to pitch in and host together, that's probably the best way to do it.
Okay.
How about can the mother of the bride host a shower?
Yeah, again, in the olden days, that was probably not a good idea. But of course she can. I mean, it depends on circumstances. If the bride doesn't live in that location and you're going back to see family, you know, it may just be convenient for the mother to host it at her home.
Okay, here's the important question that everybody wants to know. And be specific. How much should you spend on a wedding gift?
I have to say, I found this really good gift on style.com. They have this really good guide here for us. So think about, again, so many people think about it as your admission ticket, right? Mm-hmm. So how much, let's see, they're having it at the Pfister, so I should give this much. They're having it at a park, I'll only give this much. Don't think of it that way. Think about your relationship with that person. So how often do you see them? So if it's a coworker or your boss, $75 to $100. You see them every day, you want to give them something.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
A neighbor, casual acquaintance, maybe $50 to $75. Spend more if you have to, but if you have it, but you really don't have to. A friend or a relative, $100, $125.
Wow.
You like them, you want to celebrate them. Someone who's really close to you, it's worth spending a little bit more. Think about something that they might have for 20 years, and whenever they see it, they think about you, someone special. So, you know, $100 to $175. And really the least amount that you should spend, according to this guide, is $50.
Everyone in my hometown is like, would be dying right now, because at weddings in my hometown, people will put $10-$20 in a wedding card.
Right.
Yeah.
In a small town.
Oh, really quick, because we're out of time.
Yeah.
If it's a second marriage, should you register for gifts?
I don't think that there's a problem with that. I mean, the thing is, you don't want to be registering for things that you already have and you just want new stuff. So you can always do what Matt and I did, which was we didn't register anywhere. And we simply hoped that pushed people to give us cash. And all we did was turn around and pay for the wedding that way. So
that's pretty cool.
That way there was no question or anything like that.
Oh, and we tease this. Is it okay to invite someone without a guest if they are single?
No, absolutely not. Who wants to go to a wedding when you're single?
Right.
Right? And then you have to go by yourself? Please. Unless you've got a bunch of other single attractive people you're going to all set up.
Yeah.
And make it the dating game.
Yeah, don't
no.
be rude.
All right, see, I love that. You're awesome. Thank you, Laura.
Thanks, Laura.
Great
Thank
to
you.
See you. Happy New Year.